Srimati Vijila Sathyanath. Please put a specific...
Yes, I will be very specific. I know that my limitation of time. Actually, as already in the statistics, our honorable minister, vibrant minister, our friend Srimati Zubin Irani has given, but the malnutrition and infant mortality rate remains very high in India, but the budget is very meager, 4%. The budget allocated to minors consisting of 40% of Indian population. But out of 19.8 million children below the age group of 6 years are undernourished. That we have already seen. So now my point, specific point is, Anganwadi centers, how to strengthen it? Actually, comes in Tamil Nadu, there are 54,439 Anganwadi centers. Out of this, 7,517 are in rented building, which cannot cater to the needs of water, EB, toilet repairing. So health, hygiene, nutrition cannot be completely fulfilled. And it other 5,400 are in other government buildings. But my suggestion, or I want own buildings for our state, that is the construction of Anganwadi centers now has been entrusted as Manrega from 7 lakhs per Anganwadi center. In that, 5 lakhs comes from the Manrega scheme, and 2 lakhs the center share, and state has to share 60-40. But before it was 60-40, now it has been 50-50. And that too, they have to build the Anganwadi center, and then only the central government will reimburse. First they have to go. So it is an additional burden for our state, because after completion of the construction of work, this great burden comes to the states. So I request that the government of India should reconsider its decision. I also place on record that our district, Tirunelveli district collector, Srimati Shilpa Prabhakar Satish, has admitted her own child, her girl child, in an Anganwadi center, which she has set up an example for others, because she can lift the Anganwadi status and by knowing very well about its working. And Anganwadis, we have been in forefront. Our Amma has given 18,000 for the Dr. Muthulakshmi Reddy maternity benefit scheme in our state. 18,000 has been provided to the mothers, the expectant mothers. So the likewise, that scheme should also be enhanced. And the other scheme, one scheme I wanted to, before it was Rajiv Gandhi scheme for adolescent girls, Sabla. In that, the age group of 11 to 14 years, and all girls in the age group of 15 to 18 years were provided supplementary nutrition for 300 days in a year. Now, I want to know from the Honorable Minister, because now it has been restricted to the beneficiaries in the age group of 11 to 14 years. So I would like that the government of India may consider to provide supplementary nutrition to all adolescent girls in the age group of 11 to 18 years for 300 days in a year to fight malnutrition and anemia among adolescent girls who are going to become future mothers. So this has to be implemented. I have 2 more minutes. I want
to
place on record that...
Vijilaji.
I will finish it. Nutrition, health care and sanitation. In our Anganwadi centers, 11 districts, first it was introduced, Poshan Abhiyan. Now it has been extended to 21, the other 21 districts. So totally, all our districts are included. But I wanted to know from the Honorable Minister whether center-wise soups will be provided, date fruits will be provided, kitchen garden vegetables will be provided. Vegetables, they have to make it by their own. They have to make. So vegetable, kitchen garden vegetables should be made.
Thank you.
Also, underweight children should get milk.
Thank you. Now
in the Anganwadi center. Because our Amma gave, it was a nutritious supplement she gave. As a
Srimati Sampatiya,
Excuse me, sir. I wanted to know from the minister whether these supplement nutrients will be provided in the Anganwadi center. Thank you, sir.
please put very pointed clarifications. बहुत pointed clarification कृपया
धन्यवाद माननीय